हेलो, वी बी स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम दत्ता मैगी कॉलेज ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी वारानगरी नागपुर आर हियर टू प्रेजेंट ऑन द टॉपिक CPM कंटिन्यूस पैसिव मोशन एंड द मेंबर्स आर पूनम सिकदर, वैष्णवी सोमसेटवार, रेवती ताराबुरे, मंगेश ताठे एंड माधवी ठाकरे. आर कंटेंट इंक्लूड्स इंट्रोडक्शन, स्ट्रक्चर, टाइप्स, फिजियोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट, प्रिंसिपल, एप्लीकेशन, इंडिकेशन, कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेशन, प्रिकॉशंस एंड देन बेनिफिट्स. Now let's see the introduction of CPM definition. CPM refers to passive motion that is performed by the mechanical device that moves joints slowly and continuously through controlled range of motion. It is used during the first phase of rehabilitation following soft tissue surgical procedure or trauma. It is used in various types of reconstructive joint surgery. Concept was created by Robert B. Salter in 1970 with the help of an engineer, John Sarringer. It was created in 1978. Now let's move towards the structure of CPM. In this there are components. First, ankle or knee joint function change button, foot supporter, control panel, fasten band, fasten bolt, power, power support, speed button, distance control button, bar, hand controller. Types. There are three types of CPM: free linkage, anatomic, non-anatomic. In free linkage, limb moves by grasping joint proximally and distally through range of motion, adjustable for patients and contraindicated for unstable joints. In anatomic, it mimics the joint natural motion and involves joint motion. In non-anatomic, that does not replicate natural joint motion, but compensatory movement occurs between limb and the CPM unit. Now moving forwards, we will see about physiological effects. First, it encourages the remodeling of collagen along line of force. Second, it reduces the four things. First, negative effects of joint immobilization, functional shortening, cross-linking of collagen and capsular adhesions. Third, it enhances the tensile strength of tendons, allografts and skin. It also stimulates repair of articular cartilage.
Principles. Patient should be positioned in suitable and comfortable position. Provide sufficient support and stabilization of parts. Principles on which CPM concept is based are twofold. First, joint motion is necessary for maintenance of articular cartilage. Second, joint homeostasis requires maintenance of normal periarticular soft tissue compliance. CPM unit is often applied in the recovery room immediately after surgery, even when patient is wearing braces or surgical bandages. Range of motion. Arc of motion is determined, often low arc of 20 to 30 degrees initially and progress to 10 to 15 degrees per day. Rate, usually 1 cycle per second or per 2 minute. Total end range time delivers low load, prolonged stress and increases range of motion as it increases. Help patient overcome apprehension of moving joint after surgery. Decreases rate of atrophy, limits functional shortening of muscle, no increase on cardiovascular system. Duration ranges from 1 hour 3 times a day to continuous for 24 hours a day. After surgery, use is for 6 to 8 hours a day. Long-term bound patient continuously attached. Some home treatments with visit by physiotherapist. Duration minimum for CPM is usually less than 1 week when satisfactory range of motion is reached. This video shows application of CPM for knee joint. Indications: knee replacement, fracture including kneecap, tibia brachii, thigh bone, etc., arthritis, hip surgery, ligamented operated, burn, joint sepsis, after knee arthroplasty, after meniscectomy, after osteochondral repair, after surgical repair of stable intraarticular or extraarticular fracture, after joint surgery including anterior cruciate ligament. Contraindications: unwanted joint motion and overstressing, unstable fractures, spastic paralysis, uncontrolled infection, deep vein thrombosis. Continuous passive motion is contraindicated in cases for which the device can use unwanted translation of opposing bones, overstressing the healing process. Use only on firm flat surfaces. Keep hair, clothing, fingers and other loose objects away from moving parts of machine. Keep away from water and wet surfaces. Keep away from sources of ignition. Unplug when not in use. Switch power off before unplugging. Benefits: preventing development of adhesion, contracture and joint stiffness, providing a stimulating effect on the healing of tendons and ligaments. Minimizing the effect of immobilization. increasing synovial fluid of joint, so increase rate of intra-articular healing. With this, we end our presentation. Thank you.